Hi everyone. Okay, so for the first EP, we will summary on that the content of the chapter 1, 2, and 3. This is the content before the midterm exam. Okay, so let's start with the chapter 1. In chapter 1, we will talk about three main contents. So the first contents about the mathematical inductions, okay, or we call in short math induction. So to prove the sentence PN, let N be any natural numbers, right? So you have that, right? N is the set of the natural numbers or the positive integers. So we would like to show whether the sentence P ends always true. So let's start. We have to prove two steps. The first one is we have to show the basic step. That means that, right, we have to check whether when we start that n is equals 1 is true. And the second step, we have to show that the inductive step, which we have to prove the sentence that if we let that PK is true, then we need that the sentence PK plus 1 also true, which means that we have to suppose PK is true. So this means that, right, K is be any natural numbers. It's up to, right, the term N you start. Let's see examples. So the sentence we can prove whether equalities or the inequalities. Okay, so let's start easier. You know that, right? The summations of the term I, when I start from 1 to N, right? This means the sentence 1 plus 2 plus 3 until N, which equals N times N plus 1 over 2. Okay, so first we let that. Our sentence PN is this term, right? When N is any natural numbers. So we start with let N be any natural numbers, okay? And then so our term N is start from 1. Then we start with our basic step. That means that, right, our case N equal 1. Easier, right? Just prove the left-hand side and the right-hand side. So we start with the terms on the left-hand side. It's also equal 1. Okay? And then terms from the right-hand side, we have to replace the formula N times N plus 1 over 2 with 1, which equals 1. Now, we can show that the value on the left-hand side and the right-hand side equals. So we can conclude that the sentence at N equals 1 is always true. Okay. Next, we will show the inductive step or inductive hypothesis. So we let that K be any natural number. That means that, right, the value of the K is the greater than or equal 1. And then we assume or we support that PK is always true. Okay. So suppose that. Okay. So from the PK is true, okay, we found that the sentence 1 plus 2 plus 3 until k is equals to the terms k times k plus 1 over 2. But we need, okay, or we must show that the term pk plus 1 is true. That means that we need the term 1 plus 2 plus 3 until k plus 1, right? Equals on the right hand side k plus 1 times k plus 1 plus 1. It's been that equals k plus 2 equal 2. Okay, so from the first inequality, okay, so we start with equation 1, and then we add the term k plus 1, right, both left hand side and the right hand side, right on the right hand side. So you got that the term k plus 1, right, plus k plus 1, okay. Then on the right hand side, right, we factorize, right, or we get right the factors term, the k plus 1, right. And then the inside the bracket, we got that, right, k over 2 plus 1, okay. Then after that, you simplify the term, so you got that k plus 2, right, all over 2, which also equals that we need, okay, all that we need, k plus 1 times k plus 1 plus 1, okay, all divided by 2, okay. So that we need after that, right, so then we can conclude that pk plus 1 is true, right? So we got that, right? So from two step, right, then we can conclude that pn is always true, right? For every n is the natural numbers, okay. So anyway, we can prove with the inequalities. For examples, okay, so let's see on your examples, right? You have the inequality, right? 3 to the power to the n, right? Less than n factorial. This is for our n, which less than 6. That means that, right, the term n is start at 7, okay? So this is your terms pn. Okay, so we start, let n be any natural number, right, which n is less than or equal to 7. Then your the basic step is start from the case n equals 7. Okay, so we have to prove on the left hand side, right? This is the term 3 to the power of the 7th. And on the right hand side, right, which is equals the 7 factorial. Okay, so n factorial is 7. Okay. You cannot allow to use the calculator, right, on the midterm exams. But now for the homework, you also can use the calculator. Okay. So I think I will, when I'm use the calculator, we will find the power of the 3 to the power of the 7, okay, which equals 2187. Okay, and after that we find the 7 factorial, which equal 5040. Okay, so from this we can find that, right? 3 to the 7 is less than 7 factorial. Okay, then we can conclude that the basic step that needed, right? P7 is true. Okay, after that we will show the inductive step. So sometimes we need the strongly inductive step, but I think now we can use just the normal inductive step. Okay, so we support that for every, okay, so first we let that, right, K be any natural number which the term K is greater than 7. Okay, and then we suppose that the PK is true. Okay, so PK is true, so you got that the term 3 to the power of K, right, less than K factorial. Okay, and we need the term 3 to the power of the K plus 1, right, which equal 3 times 3 to the K. Okay, but 3 times 3 to the K, right, from the inductive step or the inductive hypothesis that we suppose, we found that, right, the 3 to the K also less than K factorial. Okay, and but our term, right, K less than K greater than or equal 7. Okay, so we need the north. Okay, so from this 3 also less than 7, right, and 7 less than or equal K. Okay, so from this you got that, right, this also less than, right, the term K times K factorial, right. And since K is the positive or K is the natural number, right, then we also got that the term K also less than or equal K plus 1. Okay, so from this you got that, right, this also less than K plus 1 times K factorial, which this also equal K plus 1 factorial. Okay, so now you got that, right. Then we also found that, right, the term or the sentence PK plus 1 is always true. Okay, so from both step, right, so we can conclude that PN, right, is always true, right, for all n is less than or equal 7. Okay, so that's all. So you can see that, right, the mathematical inductions, right, also can prove the sentence equalities and the inequalities. Anyway, sometimes we need more like strongly inductive, but not for every case, just some case that you need. Okay, so what is the idea of the strongly mathematical induction, right, or strongly inductions? Okay, so you have two steps, right, the same with the general induction, that for the basic step, so that in the right, the P1 is always true. But for the inductive step, normally we suppose early PK is true, right? But for the strongly mathematical inductions, we have to suppose start from PN0 or P1, right? P2 and until PK is true, are true. Okay. And after that, right, you just show that the case P1 is always true. Okay. So the strongly mathematical inductions, right, you have to suppose not only PK, but just start from the P1 until PK. So that is the difference between the general mathematical induction and the strongly induction. Okay. I think now just stop the first EP right now. Then we continue to the EP2 by